Hello everyone, good morning. I hope all of you are good and I am also fine. So today I will take another class from physics class 9. The topic is laws of conservation of linear momentum from the chapter force and Newton's law. Okay, so it will help you for the preparation of NTSC, KBPY, UPSC, SSC, TET, CTET, ND and foundation of JEE Mains and IIT. JEE Mains, IIT and NEET. So the topics is laws of conservation of linear momentum. Fine. The statement is like that: when external force acting on a system is zero, then the total linear momentum of the system remains constant. So what does it mean? If in any system the external force is zero, then there's always the linear momentum always be constant. That means remains constant. That means the initial momentum and final momentum will be equal. Okay. So let's prove it. Suppose I consider a one body here. This one is one body, and I applied the body is A and its mass is m. Okay, and its initial velocity is u. I'm applying force here. This one is external force, and its velocity increase to b. Okay, so mass will be remain same. Now here. Its initial momentum will be what? Its initial momentum will be m into u, and its final momentum will be pf equal to m into v, right? So from Newton's second law, what we get? From Newton's second law we get external force is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum. That is rate of change of momentum. That is change of momentum mv minus mu by t, right? So change of momentum is what? Del p, that is m pf minus pi, is not it? Pf minus pi, that is mv minus mu, right? Now from here we can write t is time. So I write here u equal to initial velocity and v is final velocity. Okay, m is mass of the body, and fext is external force, external applied force, right? Applied force. T is time. So now see, if external force is zero, what will happen? If external force is zero, that means external force is zero, that is ext, fext is zero, then what will be get? We'll get, that is mb minus mu by t equal to 0, is noted. We can write this one, ext equal to k into mb minus mu by t, right? Okay, this equation we can split in this way. Okay, got it this way, this much. Now mb minus mu equal to what? 0. That is mb equal to mu. So mb is what, sir? Mb is initial. Okay. Mb is final momentum. Mu is initial momentum. So in final momentum is equal to initial momentum. At what condition? If external force is applied. So since this is proved, so let me explain again. Suppose one force is applied on a body of mass m, its initial velocity is u, and after applying force, external force f, its velocity becomes, suppose, b. Okay, so initial momentum will be mu and final momentum will be mb. So changing momentum will be pf minus pi, that is final momentum minus initial momentum. Now according to Newton's second law, what we get? External force is directly proportional to the rate of change of momentum. This is the rate change of momentum, upon time, that is rate of change of momentum. So if F E X T will become K into M V minus M U by T. So here K is any constant. Okay. Now if external force is zero, if external force is zero, that is we can write that F E X T is how much? Zero. F E X T is zero, right? Okay, fine. Now just put the value of E X T here. That is zero equal to this much. That means we can say MB minus MU by T equal to zero. MB minus MU equal to zero. That is MB equal to MU. That means PF equal to PI. So what is PI? PF is initial PF final momentum and PI is initial momentum. Okay. Mas this much. This is initial momentum. This is initial momentum. And this one is final momentum. This one is final momentum. Okay. So this was what